have Salmon Cupid, who is the inventor and patent holder of the electronic pan. And today he's going to introduce another version, which is the electronic pan, electronic bass pan. So Salmon, let's welcome him.
So while it's still a prototype, so we're just going to take our time with it. It's stuck together very meticulously. Wonderful. So ladies and gentlemen, the electronic bass. So, this is a 6-bass. The firmware and all the software have been done in-house through Napink. And you'll see it's only about 5 inches in depth. And as things progresses and it goes into production stage, you'll be able to stack them each on top of each other, and it will not even be the height of a traditional bass for transporting purposes.
Let me hear you, man.
Yes, Maureen, one of my teachers from way back when. She really found it. I taught her to put in a pedal. Yes, Miss Maureen, I taught her to put in a pedal on pan. Version 2 had a pedal, this one also had a pedal. So there's, at the bottom here, you have MIDI, in, out, and through. You have sustain pedal, you have headsets, so you don't have to worry about disturbing your wife or husband while you're practicing at night. You also have audio in them. So you can take your iPad, iTouch computer, you run your song.
You want to hear the pan.
You want to hear the pan.
I'm going to put pan on while I speak here quickly. So, why? That's one of the pans in here. That's one of the tuners in here. I think the front one here. That's a behind step effect, right? And you have a different style tuner here. It's a different brightness, right? You can continue to get a little jazzish. You go again to a different four-time pan. So we have several different hand tones as things continue, as time progresses and technology continue. I will, I think I'm out of questions, but I guess there will be a question period. I need a mic. Can I get a mic over here? This young lady, I promise I'll take it.
Sensitivity of the pad.
Yes.
I found it was remarkable because I didn't expect it to be so that sensitive. I could just.
You don't have to put no sort of effort into it.
Yeah, not too much effort.
Yeah, it actually makes it easier to play because on the pan, unless you strike the exact center, you're not going to get the right tone all the time. But the fact that you can touch any part of it and get that, you know, the ideal tone all the time makes it.
All right. So we must get modernized, right? So this is like, I find this long overdue.
A lot of people think that the electronic pan, in the electronic version, I'm not saying that you say this, I'm just saying in general, the electronic version is nothing else but another type of steel pan. You know what I mean? Just like you have an acoustic guitar, you have an electric guitar, you have a piano, acoustic piano, you have an electric piano, we have an acoustic pan, we have an electric pan. You know what I mean? Feel of it.
It's amazing.
This is actually the first time I'm actually playing an E-pan. So this is version 3, yeah? How much versions? 1, 2, and 3? Right. Because of Salmon Cupid, I didn't play the first one and the second one. But I played the third one because I came and I decided that I wanted to take it upon myself to play. Right?
Flexibility.
If you're going to a studio, right, you'll see a keyboard set up in the studio, right? Yes. So a panist goes into the studio, he maybe hear a bass line, maybe hear a keyboard line, he hear a sax line, but he can't play keyboard.
Play more than one chord on this. Cut it.
My name is Marina Maffat.
I'm Salmon Cupid. Oh boy, you see the orchestral Tobago.
You can talk about it.
Alpha Pan Pioneers, Tobago also.
What I like, what I like about this is sensitivity and the response time.
You know, it's more effective than the other.
Happening. But when they touch the notes now, they touch the notes like one time, like almost instantaneously. First time actually, played an electronic part. First time.
Very nice.